Greetings to the New Testament Writings in Context course here at Lagrange College. Welcome to the summer 2018 online section for this great class. This is your instructor, Dr. Larry Asplund, coming to you. You know, this is a core course in the Lagrange College curriculum and is available in the fall and in the spring on campus, and only in the summer online. And that's really my only opportunity to teach it. So I always look forward to being able to interact with Lagrange College students and staff in the summertime. Although I live in Pine Mountain, I love Lagrange. I love Lagrange College, and any opportunity to serve is always an honor. So when you log into connect.lagrange.edu, it will take you to the dashboard of your account. You use your normal login credentials to access Connect, and then your list of classes. So you just access this New Testament Writings in Context course, and it will take you here. So I'm just going to give you a very quick introduction to what you will find in our course. Of course, the left-hand side is where the main navigation takes place. Introduction, week 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This is just a 5-week intensive, which means it's going to go by very, very quickly. But I want to do everything I can to make sure this is a great learning experience for you. So in the introduction section, you will see, you know, just some basic ideas concerning the class. There's a great Lagrange College Online Learning Tutorials, a PDF document that is really an excellent introduction to this online environment for Lagrange College. If you've not had a chance to take a look at that, I recommend you just download it and let it be a quick tutorial for you, an introduction to this online environment. And then the next thing you will find is the news forum. I'm going to post regular announcements, both written announcements and video announcements, to this forum. And so that's where, of course, I'm posting this video. And I'm going to do everything I can to keep you informed, to lead you along so that you have a great experience that makes sense to you. I'm going to try to anticipate your questions, your needs, and of course, we'll be available to interact with you all along the way. And then again, in the introductory section, the water cooler is just a place for you to say hi, to introduce yourself. You know, it's very important, even though we're only together for 5 weeks, it's very important to begin to make those personal and social connections in this class. For online learning, it's definitely been demonstrated that we learn best if we can do it with a sense that this is a real class with real people in it. And so it starts here with the water cooler. Jump in, introduce yourself, and interact then with others who come on board and introduce themselves. Let's get to know each other here before we even start week one. And then underneath that, here is your very important syllabus for this class. Everything that you need to know is there. There is a detailed, a weekly schedule as well, describing for you the assignments in this class, as well as the expectations and the schedule for those assignments. And then speaking of expectations, here is a written assignment reflection paper rubric. This is not, you know, I'm not calling it a grading rubric because it's really a performance rubric. It's a description of expectations that I will have for you doing written assignments in this class. And then here is the discussion forum performance rubric as well. We're going to have a discussion all 5 weeks. We're going to have a short written assignment all 5 weeks. And so you're going to want to immediately just take a look at these three documents. They're going to be key to your success in this class. And then real quickly, because it'll give you a sense of how we're going to work together. Week one, all 5 weeks are scheduled and divided up for us. The week one is the introduction to the New Testament writings. The dates for the class are there. And you will see a description of week one, the learning objectives for week one. And then every week I'm going to post for you some supplementary resources. So for instance, here, if I can look at it real quickly, there is I've posted some resources for you, an article on the history of Bible interpretation, another one on are the New Testament writings reliable, a recommended Bible reading app. So I will always be putting some of those, you know, extra things every week for you in this resource forum area. And then every week we'll have a discussion. You will want to come on board, and sometime in the weekend, no later than the weekend, post your initial response to the prompt, the description of the subject for our discussion. And then you're going to want to reply then by the end of the week, where for us, Wednesday is the beginning of a new week. So by midnight on Tuesday, certainly on Wednesday morning, reply to at least two other posts from other members of the class. This is an opportunity to learn together in a very interactive kind of way. And I think you're going to enjoy it. Then every week we'll have a written assignment. I'm just asking for a short 500-word reflection paper on a variety of relevant questions. And these pertain to the reading assignments for the week. So in week one, it's just, for instance, reflecting on the first century context of the New Testament, which is really the big idea for us in this class, how that differed from our own time, etc., etc. And then every week you will have a reading report. Now, if I can access this real quickly for you, this is just a one question opportunity for you to report your reading. So in the Corey text, our assigned textbook for this class, I'm just asking you to read chapters 3 through 5 in Corey, and then you will come and click the week one a text reading report, and it will take you to what is called a quiz. So I'm just going to, you know, attempt the quiz, but I just want you to see what it looks like. It's just a one question. How much of this week's reading in the text did you do? Almost, half, some, none, you know, and there are points attached to those answers. So that's all that is. And there's going to be a similar report for the Bible reading section once we get into it in week two. So every week's going to work that way. When we go to week two, you will see that the theme is the Gospels and Acts. Once again, a description of week two, the learning objectives for the week. I will be posting a variety of supplementary resources for you. Once again, there will be a discussion that I think you will enjoy immensely, interacting with each other and the relevant subject for the week. Another written assignment, a short 500 word pages, which you will submit to by just clicking this, and there will be a place for you to upload your paper. And then the week two reading, the text reading and the New Testament reading. So you'll discover that starting with week two, you will also be having assignments in the New Testament. It would be Luke and Acts in week two. And, you know, I thought, since we're having a New Testament course, it'd be good to read in the New Testament. And so week three of the letters associated with Paul, you see a very similar pattern, a predictable pattern every week, important, but simple. So there are some supplementary resources, the discussion forum, the written assignment, once again, reading report for the text and for the New Testament reading in week three. Week four is other letters, sometimes called general epistles in the New Testament. Very, very similar. Week four resources, week four discussion forum, the week four written assignment, text reading report, the New Testament reading report. And then finally, here at the end, in week five, the book of Revelation, which is just a lot of fun. You know, a lot of people are just intimidated by the book of Revelation, but it is in the New Testament. So we want to take a good look at it, which we will do. And there will be, once again, supplementary resources, discussion forum. The week five written assignment is a little bit different because every core course coming out of the religion and philosophy program has assigned to it a faith reflection paper, which is simply a way for you in the context of this course as a whole to reflect on how it has influenced your faith formation and faith journey personally. And so that's going to be the last written assignment. There's going to be, of course, the text reading and the New Testament reading is just the book of Revelation. And then at the end, I'm not showing it here, but there will be a final exam. The final exam is going to be a short answer essay exam. So it's going to be something from every section of our course. And so I'm going to, you know, what that will involve is I'll post a copy of the exam document. You will download it, save it, and then it's open book, you know, based on your reading in the textbook by Corey. And so you will just really, as a review opportunity, be able to go in and complete that as exam as a final learning exercise for this class. So that's really what's coming up in the next 5 weeks in this course. I'm really looking forward to sharing this time with you. Be sure to let me know if there's anything I can do to serve you along the way. You know, I'm going to be very much interacting with every discussion board. I will respond quickly to any email messages you send to me and so forth. So I'm looking forward to a great 5 weeks. It'll come and go very quickly, but I just pray it'll be a blessing to you. God bless you, everybody. We'll see you in class.